Good evening, God is so good. Come Holy Spirit, Lord, I pray you speak to me and speak through me and anoint the words that are coming out of my mouth, Lord of God. Man, it's been a powerful Sunday, man. God has moved so mightily all day. I've just been getting hit with the Holy Ghost. I speak say fire, hallelujah, fire, praise God. Yeah, so just powerful move at church this morning, and then this evening at 3, we had a meeting in Downsville, had some missionaries minister, and they moved powerfully in the prophetic, and man, they just, it's powerful, just powerful, praise God. God is so good. I'm just so in love with Jesus. Oh, I'm so in love with Jesus. He's just so good. He is so good. Hallelujah. I'd be so thankful too. I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful. Praise God. I don't want to be off tune there. God is so good. It's been storming. So much love. My goodness. Praise God. I'm going to share a passage of scripture. Oh, glory. God is so good and he is worthy of all of our praise. Hallelujah. Oh, my goodness. I'm so excited. I don't know what's coming, but I know it's good. God is going to be good. Praise. I just want to praise it all day and all night. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. 1 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 27, starting in verse 27. One body with different gifts. If you are the body... My goodness. Yeah. All right. One body with different gifts. I come to this store so I could have more light. One body with different gifts. Help me, Holy Spirit. 27. You are the body of the anointed one. And each of you is a unique. My goodness. Yeah. And each of you. Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Glory. Oh, my goodness. All right. You, I would try. My goodness. All right. It'll work. All right. Lord. You are the body of the anointed one. Goodness, we are the body of the anointed one. Hallelujah. How cool is that? Jesus, we are his body. The church is the body of Christ. All right? And each of you is a unique and vital part of it. God has placed in the church the following. First, the apostles. Second, prophets. Third, teachers, then those with the gifts of miracles, gifts of divine healing, gifts of revelation knowledge, gifts of leadership, and gifts of different kinds of tongues. Verse 29, not everyone is an apostle or a prophet or a teacher. Not everyone performs miracles or has gifts of healing. Or speaks in tongues or interpretation of tongues. Verse 31. but you should all constantly boil over with passion in seeking the higher gifts. And now I will show you a superior way to live that is beyond comparison. Thank you, Father, for your word. Hallelujah. Knew I was going to get it. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, I want to hit on this, and I'm going to go back to the fivefold ministry, which is, I'm going to include the prophets and apostles and prophets in this one, and teachers. So the fivefold grace offices are the prophets, are the apostles, prophets, teachers, evangelists, or the evangelists, teachers, and pastors. Anyway, so for some reason, I'm not sure why, but the church, the people just want to say that the apostles and prophets don't exist today, and I don't know where that comes from, because that's just nonsense, right? I have no clue where they came up with the threefold. Most of the time it's just a pastor, and then, you know, but they'll go with the evangelist too, but and the Sunday school, they'll go with the teacher. Some churches that don't, they just call the pastor a preacher. So I just have no clue where this come from, that they say it, the saying that died off with the apostles in the Bible or whatever. But that's just not true. That's just not true. All the gifts are for the day, for today. Hallelujah. So first we got, and this, we're going to go here. First the apostles, second the prophets, and third the teachers. Then those with the gifts of miracles, gifts of divine healing, gifts of revelation knowledge. Oh, I love me some revelation knowledge. Hallelujah. Praise God. Gifts of leadership and gifts of different kinds of tongues. Hallelujah. So I said that to say that, you know, God is bringing back the apostles and prophets in the church, and you know, I think that's where everything, I believe with all my heart, that's where just everything is went wrong with not allowing the prophets and the apostles in the church, you know, run them off. And, but I believe that's what's coming back on the forefront is the prophets and the apostles. And, you know, the churches that aren't going to allow this, there's no way it, with the things that the world's coming to, how bad it's gonna be, that the churches, there's gonna be so many churches that are shutting their doors because they're not able to stand because of the grace that God has given the apostles and prophets. You gotta think that is the fullest manifestation of God in the earth is through the apostles and prophets. And that's God, they're shutting them out of the church. You know, that's just crazy. So anyway, I believe a lot of churches are going to be shutting down. They're just not going to be able to stand just without the presence of God, right? They're not going to have the presence. Anyway, so that's just, I encourage you to go back and you can read 1 Corinthians chapter 13, starting at verse 27 through 31. Hallelujah. But I'm fixing to get home. It's late. I'm ready to go get my worship zone and then go to sleep. Hallelujah. I'm tired. The rain's got my hair. Anyway, but I'm going to pray for you. Come, Holy Spirit. Lord, I pray that distractions, I command all distractions to leave from each person that watching this video right now in Jesus' name. Lift up off of them in Jesus' name. Man, I pray that y'all just be filled with so much peace. Hallelujah. And that God fill you with knowledge and speak to you and give you wisdom and speak truth about how the Lord would want you to see and view how you're supposed to really view the apostles and prophets today. You know what I mean? Hallelujah. they are still here for today, and praise God. And we need to honor our apostles and our prophets and our teachers and evangelists and pastors, the ministers that are out doing the will of God. We just need to honor our brothers and sisters. Praise God. All right. Y'all have a blessed night and go in peace, or morning, and go in peace in Jesus' name.